I will as well. Okay, so as far as I am aware, we are streaming live to YouTube, to, I believe, my personal profile. Don't know if you want to have a look, Charlotte, and see if it's going there as well. And also to the Lifestyle Marketeer Facebook group. So, Charlotte, just have a quick look. Are we in the Facebook group?
Live in the group. And live on your profile. Yep.
Ah, very interesting. In the group. Perfect. Awesome. We're a tiny, tiny little bit early. So to fill a few minutes, obviously today, before I kind of dive into that, I'm joined here today by lovely Charlotte Lee, as you can see on the screen. Say hello, Charlotte.
Yo. Hello.
Yo. So Charlotte's basically joining me to share her story. Not just from working with me, but we're going to go right back, right? We're going to go right back to maybe not quite when you're a baby, but not far away. And we're going to hear the full story of Charlotte Lee and how she ultimately went from teaching English in Vietnam, I believe, if I remember, about 18 months ago when you first came across me and we started working together, right?
Yep.
How she transitioned out of being a English teacher and into her own very successful digital advertising, coaching, and consulting business. So we're going to dive into that in just a moment. We're still a couple of minutes early, so I'm letting a few people just jump on. And in the meantime, here's the song you requested. We call these intro, the walk-in tracks. Time after time. So Charlotte's intro music. Who can guess it? Drop us a comment below. Who's watching? Where are you watching from? Joined today by the champion. The one. The only. Charlotte Lee! Little sweaties going on there. Damn good intro. Boom. Done. And we're straight into it. Just about 2 p.m. where I am, 12 p.m. where you are, Charlotte, and whatever time it is for those people who are joining us. So we are actually for the first time live on our YouTube channel. If you're watching there, hit subscribe, turn on your notifications so you get updated with the new videos, new content that I am focusing on bringing out. If you're watching in the Facebook group, awesome. Welcome. Please do drop a comment below. Let us know who's watching. Let us know where you're watching from. Because this is really a very big interview and one that I've been super excited to actually get Charlotte on to talk about her journey and her story, because it's an insane one. It's a phenomenal one. You've done so well to get to where you are. And we want to hear it, right? We want to hear the trials, the tribulations, everything. So, Charlotte, welcome. Do you want to say hello to the marketeers or the potential marketeers who are maybe following us right now?
Yeah, definitely. Hey guys, I'm well excited to be here. I'm well excited to kind of tell my story, unleash it all,
and learn lots of lessons from Charlotte's trials and tribulations as well as my own. So let's just summarize. So Charlotte, how long have we been working together in terms of when you first started working with me inside the Lifestyle Marketeer program? When was that?
So I joined the Lifestyle Marketeer in February 2019, I think it was. Cool. So it's coming up 2 years, but been working one-to-one with you for about 6 months.
Cool. So it's about 18, 19 months since you kind of came across me and we started working together. And yes, we have worked together one-to-one now for the last sort of five months or so. And for about the last year as well, because of the progress that you've made, well, the progress that you made very quickly and the success that you had inside your own digital advertising business. You've actually been a coach with me inside the Lifestyle Marketeer program now for how long? About a year, bang on, right? Yeah, so you progressed insanely quickly, and it's that progress and the lessons that came from it that I think everybody who's watching this wants to learn. So let's just dive in. Charlotte, just give us a little bit of background on yourself. Who, I nearly said, who are you, but who were you, you know, growing up? Where are you from? What did you do? What kind of jobs did you do? And what made you leave the UK to go abroad in the first place? Just give us a little bit of kind of basic background on you, please, Charlotte, for everyone. Sweet.
So I live about an hour from London, Buckinghamshire, if anyone's heard of it, or obviously lives nearby. So, I mean, pretty normal upbringing up until kind of 14, 15, 16. Got my first job when I was 15, 16 at a supermarket. Again, it's pretty bog standard compared to a lot of people. Got a supermarket job. I've always been quite ambitious, and I've always been wanting to push myself in every kind of aspect of my career and life. So even the first job that I got, I was kind of thinking from the get-go, right, I'm going to be a team leader here, I'm going to be a manager, I'm going to work my way up, even from kind of 15, 16 when I started. Left school and was like, I have no idea what I want to do. All I know is I want to go on holiday a lot. I want to kind of have the freedom. And again, I kind of had that mindset that I had when I first joined you and the Lifestyle Marketeer, even from back when I was 15, 16, I just didn't know what it was or how I could do it. So working in a supermarket kind of gave me that sort of freedom, because it's shift work and they're pretty relaxed with holidays. So to a certain extent, I could go on weekends away and do a little bit of traveling. But I got to like 18, 19 and the job that I was in, the supermarket that I worked at, got made redundant from there, and kind of thought, right, if I'm not going to leave now, if I'm not going to go and travel and actually leave the UK, I'm just going to go to another supermarket doing the same job that I'm doing now, which was, you know, good money for my age. It was, you know, I enjoyed it. So I knew if I didn't leave and didn't kind of travel, yeah, see new places, I would just go to another supermarket, go to another chain and keep working my way up, and that'd be, yeah, it.
Yeah. So when did you leave, and when did you move abroad, like initially? What sparked the expat journey for you?
So I left in probably 2016, but originally it was just, I want to travel, I want to be a backpacker, I want to do the same route that everyone else does around Thailand and Southeast Asia. And then got out there and just loved it. It was just so different to what I did at home and what I expected.
Yeah. Then what happened?
So fell in love with, before I actually went to Southeast Asia, I was in Australia for a while. I worked in Australia, which I loved, but you really quickly find yourself fall into the same pattern than you do in the UK. It's quite similar.
Yeah.
So went back to Southeast Asia and luckily knew a couple of people that said, hey, we've got a teaching position available. Obviously they paint this amazing picture of, you know, you get to help all these people, you get paid to live in, you know, Southeast Asia, you get your accommodation included. So I'm thinking, great, I'd have to pay for accommodation, I'm going to save some money and I can keep traveling. So
and what happened?
Taught for a little bit in Thailand and then went to Vietnam and taught in Vietnam for about 8 months. And it was all right in the beginning. Yeah. It was enjoyable.
I was about that. Yeah. What was your experience with teaching?
Very quickly, it becomes very intense and you kind of become at their beck and call, the school that you work for. So the freedom very quickly goes in terms of days off, evenings, even to be able to go to places nearby. The pay was like nowhere near enough for me to even live the life I wanted to live in one place, never mind be able to actually travel to different places. And it was only about like 8 weeks into the job that I found myself in that same circle, get up, go to work, maybe have a beer in the evening, go to bed, wake up the next morning.
It came onto you really quickly then, like within 8 weeks, you kind of felt like, did you feel like, or did you know that that wasn't the career path for you? That wasn't the role for you?
Yeah. So literally within 8 weeks, and then I stuck it out for about another 6 months because I really had no idea where else to go. It was either that or go home to the UK, which I didn't want to do. And at the time, it was kind of making the choice between two bad situations.
Yeah.
Put up with it. Started doing some one-to-one tuition. I thought if I can save enough money, I can go somewhere else. A different school will be better. A different place would be better. And just thought if I keep my head down for 6 months, I'll save up enough money to be able to do what I want to do. Got to the end of that 6 months and I probably had just enough money to get halfway home.
Right.
On a flight.
Yeah. So that kind of wraps up, you know, your experience with teaching, but like, what was the first step to get into where you are right now? Like at what point did you decide to make a change? How did you hear about me? What went on there?
Yeah, I'd seen your ads on Facebook pop up a couple of times and I'd heard about what it is that you and other people do as well.
Yeah.
And I just kind of thought in the beginning, well, I can't do that. I'm just a teacher. I have no experience. It's not possible. And I remember one day really specifically where I'd worked maybe like 3 weeks, 14-hour days every single day. And I remember having this day off and thinking, I'm going to get myself together this day. And at like 7 o'clock in the morning, a teacher came in, knocked on my door, kind of let themselves in. Someone's called in sick. You have to come and cover. Mm. And I literally remember in that moment thinking like, this is it. I need to get out of this. I need to change. And literally in that moment, I think your ad must have come up on my Facebook newsfeed again. And I just thought, you know what? I need to at least have a chat with him because there's got to be something better than what I'm doing at the moment.
Yeah. So you obviously, you had a conversation with one of my team. I don't know who it will have been then. You made the decision to work with me and with my team. What was that like? What was that like, making a decision to... start your own venture, invest in yourself. What was that, you know, what was that feeling like, your very first kind of experience with starting your own business, really?
Yeah, the first like 5 or 10 minutes, I was scared. I was so scared and thinking, oh my God, what have I done? But literally as soon as I kind of got a glimpse of the community and the training and just kind of saw what it was again, like I was so excited to like just learn something new. And as I started going through the training, I was buzzing about how it all fit together, how I started, you know, really becoming a business and how my mindset started to shift as well. Looking back on it now, only very subtly compared to the changes that were going to happen. And I kind of put my head down and started working on my business for about 2 or 3 months and really like pushing forward. But I think for me, I want things to happen yesterday.
And
things weren't happening as quickly as I wanted them to. And I wanted it to grow. I wanted to have a really successful business. And again, like, I remember having literally one conversation with you on a Q&A call where you were like, right, change this. You're not doing this right. You need to change your mindset with this. And literally after that call, everything just like fell into place. But before then, it was super, super exciting. But I just needed that kind of guidance. I think if I didn't have that guidance, I know we speak about this quite a lot, people going it alone and people trying to, you know, do the courses and doing it on their own. If that was me, I would have just given up at that point.
Just describe to people perhaps who are watching who don't work with us, right? Who aren't familiar with the digital advertising business model, who are like, you know, looking at sums of money that people are making going like, oh, that, you know, must be fake or whatever. Like, what do you actually do in your business? Tell us about where your business is at right now. What do you do for your clients, and why do they pay you so much money? How, like, just give us an insight into the business that you're running as a result of making a decision to learn digital advertising.
Yeah, so I work with fitness professionals, so gym owners, predominantly boot camp owners, who essentially have a business, have a really successful business, but have no idea how to bring new people in.
New customers in,
yeah. So I teach them through forms of paid advertisement, how to bring new customers into their business in a time efficient way as well.
So this is right now. This is where you are 18, 20 months into your journey, right? You've now got, but wrong question from me.
Are you going back? I see.
18 months ago, let's start from the beginning. What were you doing in your business? Who were you working with? What lessons did you learn out of those first few months? And then we'll talk about where you are now with your own clients, like right now. Because there was a transition that I want to cover on this call. I want people to learn about as well. The transition that Charlotte's made over the last 18 months. Let's start at the beginning. Just start with the first few months, right?
Yeah,
what were you trying to do? What lessons did you learn that are the biggest takeaways for everybody else here as well at that stage?
Yeah, so started running ads for fitness professionals, for personal trainers, for gyms. To essentially bring new customers into their business. The first couple of months that I did it, that's exactly what I did. I ran ads, and I charged nowhere near enough for the customers that I had coming in. And the reason I didn't charge enough is because I thought I was running ads, which is not, you know, in the grand scheme of things, it's not what I was doing. And I only saw the initial value that I delivered in that 1 month. So moving forward, you know, between month three and almost kind of month 8, 9, 10 was the biggest transition where I realized that actually I don't just bring new customers into the business. I help in, you know, the sales process. I help in the scaling of their business, how to kind of give them the life that they want rather than just extra revenue, actually allow them to reach their destination.
Yeah. The specific type of business that you decided to work with was fitness businesses, right? Personal trainers, gyms. Why? Why did you decide to work with fitness businesses and not anything else? Was there any reason for choosing that niche? You know, for those people who are at a place in their business where they're trying to decide what business should I work with? What made you choose personal trainers? Is there any reason to it?
I think it's choosing something that you're passionate about. Over and above whether you have a network or whether you have previous experience, because I think you can have previous experience and you can have a network in any industry, in any business, but if you don't enjoy that niche or that industry, it's never going to become a sustainable business for you. Like, I get up every day and I'm excited to learn more about what my clients are doing because I love fitness.
Yeah, here's a massive one for, you know, anybody who's watching this as well who's thinking about what type of business could I work with? Who would I enjoy working with? For me, it's about alignment, right? So alignment in who you're actually working with, what you're helping them do, and obviously how that benefits them, right? It's having an alignment with the people that you work with so you enjoy working with them. Do you feel like you had that with personal trainers? Was there some alignment there? You say you enjoy it, but like, do you like working out? What's your own personal personality like? Did that have an impact on who you decided to work with, who you decided to focus your business around?
Yeah, 100%. I love working out. I love keeping fit, eating well, mindset and all that kind of stuff. But also I'm very bubbly. I'm very relaxed and casual. Going for a very kind of professional industry probably wouldn't have suited my personality. So yeah, as you said, it's alignment with the type of people that you're going to be working with and not forcing yourself to be someone that you're not, because that will drain you really quite quickly.
Absolutely. And what were the biggest lessons that you kind of learned in that first few months patch before we move into where your business then evolved to afterwards? What were the kind of the best, the lessons and the takeaways out of the first, because let's face it, the first month to 2 months, you know, a month or so is like the toughest time, because you've got all of these platforms to learn. You've got, you know, like the learning curve is pretty steep. So in that first month or two, what was the biggest lesson that you took out of getting started the first month or two?
Yeah, I think the first month or two, because you're learning everything, I don't know if it's different for everyone else, but I found it really still quite exciting and I was moving forward. And it was actually after I'd finished the training and I didn't create a six-figure business in a week. So I think it's the time that it takes to actually build a business, but also understanding that pretty much everything that happens in your business is down to you. And I think that's the biggest lesson I had, because in the beginning I was kind of blaming everything else and everyone else for the reason that I wasn't moving as far, you know, moving forward as I'd want to. So I think it's that responsibility being on you and being able to take that accountability.
Yeah.
And then actually being able to value myself as well. That's probably the biggest lesson I learned.
Mm.
Actually, how valuable, you know, is the skill set that I have?
Yeah.
How valuable my time is to people. I think for me, that's the biggest transformation that I've had over the last kind of year or so. And on reflection of that, obviously then being able to scale my business because I believe that I'm worth a certain amount of time or a certain amount of money to other people. Yeah.
Absolutely. So started in about February 2019. You started working with me about a year after that in the one-to-one group. Right. So how has your business grown? What's been the evolution of your business from when you first started it? Volumes of clients, monthly income, type of business model that you've got, because you've now got a different type. Just tell us about that. How has your business evolved over the last 18 months or so?
Yeah. So I guess I kind of never had a problem with retaining clients. A lot of my clients, they've been with me for a long period of time. The evolvement came from figuring out how to help them next, because it almost felt like they had plateaued in what we were doing together, similar to what my business had done. It was doing well, but there was physically nothing else I could have done other than creating more hours in the day if I wanted to continue doing what I was doing. So that was the biggest kind of thought process when I jumped in with you and wanted to change and actually be able to help more people, but for me, work less.
What were you making at the point of joining the one-to-one group? Or like, you know, because it didn't take you 12 months to get there. So like, how long did it take you to hit your kind of income goals right from scratch? And at what point when you started working with me one-to-one, where were you at? Let's talk clients, revenue, let's talk figures. So after, when was like your best month? You know, you start from zero, then what happened? Month 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Tell us.
Cool. So yeah, I hit my revenue goal when I first started was to match my revenue from my old job, which was about $1,500 a month ish. And I think I hit that when working with fitness professionals month 2, so about 8 weeks in to working with fitness professionals. And for the first couple of months it stayed at that. I was kind of getting around retaining clients, bringing new people in. And then from about October, November, which was about 5 or 6 months in, it just kind of shot up. I kind of hit that eureka moment. And then, you know, between 6 months and a year, it then inconsistently hit 10K. So I knew I could do it, but I couldn't do it every month. And it kind of floated between 6 to 10K over the next 6 months.
Yeah. So at that point, how many clients were you working with when you were making 6 to 10K? How many clients just on average?
Between probably 8 and 10.
Cool. So you're working with between 8 and 10 clients, making between 6 and 10K a month for about 6 months, right? For about that 6 month period. So then at the end of that 6 month period, when you heard about my, when I launched the one-to-one and the advanced program for those people who now have successful digital advertising businesses to take that to the next level, what was your motivation? You mentioned time. It was to take some time back. What was your motivation for taking your business up a gear? What did you want to achieve by working with me now one-to-one once you had your digital advertising business up and running consistently, bringing in 6 to 10K with clients? What was the goal from that?
Yeah, two main things really. So one, again, as I said before, the clients that I had, I'd retained for a long period of time. And I was very aware that they wouldn't stay with me much longer if I couldn't produce the next big thing, right? Mm. It was getting not boring because we were still bringing in results, but I was very aware there was people out there that could do more. And I knew they knew that as well. And the second thing, I guess, for me, that the biggest thing was being able to take time back for myself, to be able to go on holidays, to be able to spend time with my family without feeling like I'm stuck to my laptop or feeling like I'm stuck to my phone because I'm controlling the ad campaigns that we're running, or I'm kind of controlling what they're doing. If I can almost teach people how to do it, I thought, I'm then more of a, I can take a step back and actually enjoy, you know, the money that I'm making, the success that I've had, rather than feeling guilty for taking a day off from my phone or from my laptop.
So you wanted a way. So at this point, you'd been working in your own digital advertising business for about 12 months and you'd built up a 6 to 10K a month income working with 8 to 10 clients. Now, naturally, this is hilarious because, you know, you speak to people who are just starting, who just want to start a business, right? And they tell you that this is where they want to be. And then when they get there, it's this principle called Heaven and Hell Island, right? You have this vision in your mind that, like, this is where I want to get to. And it absolutely is when you're first starting out. You want to get to 3, 5, maybe like Charlotte, you know, 8 to 10 clients. And you want to get back that control. You want to be working for yourself. You want to be working with your clients. You don't want to have to rely on a boss and all of those kind of things that go along with like normal life, right? And then when you achieve it or overachieve it, like Charlotte did, she's now got 8 to 10 clients, is making 6 to 10K a month. But there's got to be, you know, an easier way of scaling past and beyond 10K a month, which there absolutely is. So one common thing that, you know, here, I call it, it's actually heard that from a guy called Travis Sago, the Heaven and Hell Island. So when you've got this Heaven Island in your mind and you work towards it, when you actually get there, the things that we're required to do to actually get you there quickly become the undesirable. And you now want the next thing, right? The next goal, the next challenge. You want to restructure your business model to give you more time back, for example. And that's what Charlotte did. So Charlotte, what was it? Not quite 6 months, about 5.5 months ago now, you started working with me one-to-one with that goal in mind. So can you just, this is more so for the benefit of, you know, people who now have a successful digital advertising business and they're now thinking, you know, I've got a handful of clients, I'm making good money a month, I've forgotten about being an employee and being a teacher and in a job, which is awesome. But like, where do we go from here? Where have I now taken you over the last 6 months? And what's been the result of that? So 6 months ago, you were making 6 to 10K, 8 to 10 clients, doing how many hours a week, would you say?
30 to 40-ish.
30 to 40. So still not terrible, but
it's more the mindset of I need to always be switched on. It was the inability to be able to switch off. Yeah.
Right. Got it. So that's where you were 6 months ago. What have helped you do in your business now over the last five and a half months? What's been the result of working with me one-to-one?
Yeah, I think the biggest things have just been consistency, and I love it. It's fun. Like, my business is fun again. That's probably the biggest thing that I've missed. So, you know, obviously the revenue that I've been able to make since working one-to-one with you has been incredible. Like, I had my first 20K month in June, like in the middle of lockdown, where I thought, oh my God, my business is going to die. My business is going to go under. It's actually been the most successful that it's ever been. But, you know, for me, it's been the fun of being able to want to come into my business and prospect in different ways, actually be able to help people with a sustainable offer and consistently know that I can hit 5 figures a month. Like a 10K month is now quite disappointing for me. Whereas before it was a big celebration of, yeah, I hit 10K. I probably won't do it next month.
Yeah.
So it's being able to scale, but like have fun in the process.
Let's talk a little bit about that scale then. So, because we've pivoted, you're obviously not the only person in the one-to-one group who is learning this type of business model for their business as well. But like we've pivoted your what we call done for you offer. So for everybody who's in the Lifestyle Marketeer, that's the done for you business model where you're actually doing and delivering the service for your clients yourself. Right, done for you, right? You're doing it for them. Now, once you get to a certain point, a certain size, and a certain level of volume of clients, experience, results, credibility, all of these kind of things, the most sensible way of going from, like Charlotte did, you know, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10K a month to hitting 20K a month and beyond, you don't do the same things, you don't keep doing the same things, but twice as much to get to the next income goal, to get to the next time freedom goal, right? Control goal, whatever you want to call it. And that realization for Charlotte was like, you know, you don't keep doing everything that you're currently doing now to get to the next level. And I know there's so many people that have that belief that you just keep doing more of the same thing. It doesn't work like that. That's not how it works. You do more of the same to get to, you know, 3, 5, 8, 10K max, like a push really. Possibly, you know, we've got some people who have hit 15, 17 up to 20, right? With the done with you model, done for you model. But the most sensible way and the way in which you can get a lot more of your time back and you can sell at a much higher price point is to transition to something called the done with you model, where you're actually delivering and doing the work with your client. So you're essentially enabling them to complete the work themselves with you as support. So what has shifted into that consulting type business model, Charlotte? What has that done for you in terms of time, you know, getting back even more of the time that you were spending working with your clients? What's that done for your life and business, shift into a done with you business model?
Yeah, just massive, massive things. I can't wait until the pandemic has kind of blown over, because I think of all the amazing things that I can do and all the amazing holidays I can go on. But right now, like, it's just incredible. Like, I work probably 20, 25 hours a week max on things that I want to do. And I can switch off. That's the biggest thing. I know that it's my clients' responsibilities to do what they need to do to grow their business. I can actually switch off because I'm not physically responsible for anything other than keeping them on the straight and narrow and giving them the proven structures, which for me it didn't feel like a lot had changed. But from talking to my mum, my partner, my family, you know, they all make comments about how much more in the room with them I am, which is just massive. It means, you know, I've switched off. I can actually enjoy my life, being spend time with them, which is just a massive difference to what I was doing, you know, beginning of this year.
So you basically, just to summarize that, I think this is a cool way of putting it, you basically more than doubled your business in terms of revenue and income that you're making. And beyond that, not just doubling your business, but you've like, would you go as far as say it's half the time, or maybe not quite half the time, but
I'd say it feels like half. It feels like less than half now, because I'm not constantly switched on.
Yeah, I think we also want to hit on as well something, another massive thing that you've achieved as well lately, buying your own house, right? So when I first started working with Charlotte 18 months ago, obviously you can imagine the kind of place that she was in, just as in a personal development, mental headspace type of place, from teaching English, running around the world, not knowing where to go or what to do and what she actually wanted to do, to now in 18 months time doesn't happen overnight. This is, you know, Charlotte is an inspiration to a lot of people to building a multiple five figure a month business, working 25 odd hours a week. And she's just bought her first house in not too far away from London, right? 18 months into the journey. So I think that, just everybody drop a congratulations to Charlotte below in the comments for that, because that on its own is just, given, you know, the state of the economy and the world and everything, that's a massive achievement just in itself. So personally, I want to say congratulations and well done. I'm sure there's lots of other people who will also be jumping in the comments right now saying it too. So please do drop a message below. That's huge. That's massive. But buying back that time, almost, that's almost what you're doing, right? Once you get your business to a certain level, you've got, you know, even 2, 3, up to 5 clients, and you're making a certain amount of money in your digital advertising business, the sensible way of leveling up your business and getting to the next stage, it's not to keep doing the same thing over and over and over again. That's where you get started, right? That's where you cut your teeth, you land your first few clients, you transform, because it is a transformation, isn't it, Charlotte? Let's talk a little bit about the personal development side.
Yeah,
so this is massive. And I've got, by the way, everybody who's watching, I've got a massive, massive, massive announcement on Thursday. So make sure you stay tuned. Huge announcement on Thursday, which I'm buzzing for, which is all personal development, funnily enough, related. So let's just talk to finish off a little bit about that, because I know we've been on half an hour or so now, but I know the biggest thing for most people who are not just starting out, but people, you know, invest in themselves once, they learn skills to build a certain type of business, and now they want to get to the next level, like that continuous flow of education to keep moving forward is not just important on a tactical and skill level, but also on a personal development level. So what are kind of the lessons and takeaways that you've had of working with me directly, and how has that impacted you and your business, motivation wise and moving forward? First question.
Yeah. So motivation is, you know, do something that you love, and it comes down to the niche that you choose, the way that you position yourself in your business. If it's something that you love, the motivation will come naturally because you want to be there. And just kind of flipping back to my biggest lesson from the beginning, only you are responsible for your journey. So once you get to the end point that you decided, you know, this is where I'm going to sit for a bit, it's, you know, it's only your responsibility to keep moving forward, to keep learning what you want to learn. And the best way to do that is find someone that's already there and learn from them, because you'll miss out the mistakes. You'll miss out, you know, months or years of things that you could do wrong. And just,
absolutely,
you know, keep yourself motivated as well, because you're actually going to make progress, make faster progress. Therefore, you know, you're going to be more motivated to move forward and succeed.
What about those lessons for people just getting started out? So obviously there's going to be people watching this now, like looking at you going, oh, I wish I was in her position in 18 months. And first of all, you absolutely can be. There's obviously a lot of work to do in the meantime. But just for those people who are at that position, mindset wise, what are the biggest takeaways that you've got for people who are sitting where you were 18 months ago? What's your advice to those people?
Yeah, my biggest advice is you have to start somewhere. So if you remember, my first revenue goal was to match my salary from my old job. You know, you have to start somewhere, and that has to be a goal that you work towards. And I push this on my clients so much. Taking action is scary and taking action is uncomfortable, but not taking any action is deadly.
Yeah. Massive. Not taking any action means you're definitely not going to get anywhere. In fact, you're going to go backwards because time is ticking. Anyway, enough on that. Charlotte, I want to say a massive, massive thank you for you taking the time to come and do this interview with me on the brand new one and multiple channels at the same time. How exciting. Yeah, so thank you very much. I think it's fair to say, you know, Charlotte also coaches inside the Lifestyle Marketeer program, given the speed and the efficiency that she actually took building her own business. She also coaches inside the Lifestyle Marketeer program. So everybody who's watching who works with us, Charlotte will be a very familiar face. I'm sure now after this interview, you're going to have even more respect for her and what she's actually already achieved. After working in a supermarket for the majority of your adult life, right, until you've found the right thing for you. Nothing wrong with working in a supermarket if that's what you want to do, but congrats to Charlotte. She saw something else, she went after it, and she got it. So I think that in itself is a massive lesson for everyone. Hope you've enjoyed this interview. If you're watching on YouTube, make sure you hit subscribe, turn on the bell, the notification. Same in the group as well, so you actually get notifications when we do interviews, live trainings, and all of the other good stuff that we are going to be doing for you. So drop us a comment below. Let us know what you thought to that interview, and we'll see you very soon. Charlotte, any last words for the Lifestyle Marketeer following fan base?
No, I think you smashed it. So just take some action. Keep moving forward.
Here's a massive one I'm going to talk about. Show up.
Yep. Show
up, attend Q&As, ask questions, get yourself involved in the community, work hard, persist, and you very well could be sitting where Charlotte is in X amount of time, right? Cool, really enjoyed it. I'll see you all on Thursday for a massive announcement. Make sure you turn all of those notifications on everywhere. That's going to be a huge one. I'll also be announcing it by email tomorrow, but I'm going to keep you in the dark for a little bit. Cool. Peace and love, everyone. Have a wicked day. Keep doing what you're doing. I'll see you in the group.
Bye, guys.